Welcome to Smart Catalyst Jan 5, 2019. So today we are going to see all these articles. The first one is Open Defecation Continues Unabated. The second one is Data Protection Law. Third one is the Norms on Commodity Exchanges. And fourth one is Exempt on Foreign Made Drugs from Price Control. And the fifth one is Lok Sabha okays the bill to make Aadhaar linkage voluntary. And the sixth one is Over 20,000 hectares of forest land diverted, but clearances get stuck. And the seventh one is Swachh Sarvekshan, and the eighth one is Submarine Cable System, and the last one is DBT Scheme for Nutritional Support. So the first article is Open Defecation Continues Unabated. So what the news here is, a new research on the impact of Swachh Bharat Mission in the rural parts of four northern states were conducted recently, and as per the research, they found like while the open defecation has fallen and the toilet ownership has increased, but the percentage of the people who own the toilets but continue to defecate in the open has remained unchanged between the year 2014 till 2018. So it indicates that the Swachh Bharat mission is more successful in terms of toilet construction, but it is not that much good in terms of changing the behavior of the people. So more toilets are getting constructed, but not the people are using that properly. They are still defecating in the open. So if you see in this picture, despite the availability of toilet at their homes, closely 25% of the people are defecating in the open in 2014. But still, this proportion has stayed the same even in the year 2018. So this is what they proposed in this article. So we all knew about this Swachh Bharat mission, right? It is aiming to eliminate the open defecation across the country by October 2, 2019. And as per this mission, almost 60% of the households which are covered by this survey, which didn't have the toilet in 2014, are now having one. So it is a positive thing about the mission's implementation. But the major concern here is approximately 44% of the people over 2 years old in the rural areas of the four surveyed states, which is Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan and Uttar Pradesh, they are still defecating in the open. And some other facts in the same report is Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan are ODF states, that is open defecation free states, they are 100% achieved. And Uttar Pradesh has achieved the 100% coverage of toilets, but it is yet to be declared as ODF. And Bihar is nearly to achieve, this is 98.97% coverage. So this finding is based on a 2018 survey, which covered nearly 9,800 people in these four states. And the researchers visited the same areas and same families which are participated in a similar 2014 survey, which had showed that nearly 70% of the people then defecated in the open. But now it changed like from 70% to 44%, but still they are defecating in the open. Okay. So also in the same report, the seven cities which all are in Madhya Pradesh and in Chhattisgarh have been certified ODF++. So what does this ODF++ means? They are an extension of ODF protocol, which means all the fecal sludge and the sewage in these cities is treated scientifically before discharging it into the water bodies. So they actually properly treated the waste and then only they are discharging it. If suppose any city is doing that, then it is being certified with this ODF++. And it is conducted only for Swachh Bharat mission of urban cities. So these kind of data, which is about the implementation of the Swachh Bharat mission, has been surveyed as per the Swachh Sarvekshan of 2019. So which is conducted regularly by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. So the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs is also planning to set up a submission on these kind of sludge management under its Amrut scheme for 500 cities and towns. So now, apart from this Swachh Bharat mission, under this Amrut scheme, they are planning to introduce this kind of submission for the proper implementation of the fecal sludge management in these towns and cities. Okay. So if you see here, this is how they actually declare ODF, ODF plus and ODF plus plus. Okay. So this all indicate that now all the cities are good at construction of toilets, but focus should not only be on construction alone. We should make and sustain the cities to be open defecation free also. And we should move beyond the toilets. So this is what they actually proposed. That is, beyond toilets in the sense, we should focus on fecal waste management, liquid waste management by addressing the entire service chain of the sanitation. So we should focus on entire service chain of the sanitation. So now we are going to see about this Amrut scheme. Amrut is the new avatar of Jawaharlal Nehru National Urban Renewal Mission, and this majorly aims to ensure the basic infrastructure services which is relating to water supply, transportation and development of green spaces. So this is the major objective of this Amrut mission. So under this mission, nearly 10% of the budget allocation will be given to the states and union territories as incentives based on their achievement of reforms during their previous year. So how they performed in the previous year, based on that they are giving their incentive, okay, to the state as well as the union territories. So Amrut will be implemented in 500 locations which is having a population of 1 lakh or above, and apart from that the central assistance will also be provided to the states as well as the union territories which is having a population of more than 10 lakh, and it is the amount is up to the extent of 50% of the project cost for cities and towns. So now we are going to see about the fourth edition of Swachh Sarvekshan. So what is this Swachh Sarvekshan means? It is the SBM, which is the Swachh Bharat Mission's annual cleanliness survey, okay, and they are going to rank the cities and towns based on their sanitation efforts. So they are going to get the sanitation efforts detail on the basis of third party surveys as well as the citizens' feedback. So if you are going to see, the fourth edition of this annual survey is launched in New Delhi on Friday, and this will be conducted across 4,200 towns and cities between Jan 4 to Jan 28. So why they are doing these kind of survey means, in order to foster a spirit of healthy competition among the cities as well as the towns. So if you rank the cities, then obviously they are going to perform better in order to get top into the rank, right? So if you are going to see what is the difference between the surveys which was conducted before and now, means there is a major change in the parameters and their weightage. So before, 35-30% of weightage is given to service level progress of towns and cities, citizen feedback as well as the direct observation, but now they have changed the weightage like 25-25-25 for these three things, and they included a new parameter which is the certification, and it has a weightage of 25%. So what this certification means, if any city or town is going to perform well in ODF or any kind of targets which is set by the government, then the government is going to give the certificate to those towns and cities, right? So those certificates which is collected by each and every city is now having a weightage of nearly 25%. Okay, so these are the top 10 cities in the 2018 survey. So now they are going to conduct 2019 survey. Okay. So this kind of Swachh surveys is now being conducted by an independent third party under the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, and it will be a digital and paperless survey, and they are going to give star rating for garbage free cities. Okay, so cities will be evaluated on the basis of star rating they achieve. So it is going to cover nearly 40 crore people across the country, and it is having a time of 28 days for completion of the entire survey. So the next article is data protection law finalized. So what the news here is, the government has finalized the data protection law, and it will be soon introduced in the parliament, and it is set by Ministry of Electronics and IT. So what they actually finalized means, they finalized certain guidelines for the social media intermediaries such as the FB, Twitter, YouTube, Google, etc. That means the crucial personal data of the Indian citizens has to be processed in centers located within the country, and it should not be outsourced to any other countries. And if suppose anyone is violating that, then the financial penalties are imposed on those data processors whoever violating the protection law. So if you see in this picture, nearly 2000 fraud cases or electronic banking fraud cases are observed in the year 2017 to 18 itself. So why we need these kind of data protection law means, the companies in the West, say for example Google, they have collected the data of the Indians related to all the aspects of the lives of the Indians, and there might be a possibility that they can manipulate the data and make it to their advantage, and it will lead to the direction of neo-imperialism. So in order to avoid that only, the government is now introducing this kind of data protection law in order to protect the data of the Indian citizens. So the next article is, SEBI tweaks the norms for commodity exchanges. So what the news here is, the SEBI has recently changed the disclosure norms. What they change means, the commodity derivative exchanges now have to disclose the amount of trading done by the farmers as well as by the other commodity market participants on a weekly basis in a public platform. So what should be disclosed by the derivative exchanges means the open interest as well as the turnover of various categories of participants. And whoever the participants, like the farmers, the FPOs, the value chain participants, and the proprietary traders, foreign participants, as well as the domestic financial institutional investors. So all these people's interest and the turnover has to be now disclosed openly in the public platform in a weekly basis. So who are those value chain participants means? The processors, the importers, exporters, producers, wholesalers, everyone who is participating in the value addition of any product. Now they are coming under this value chain participants. So now we are going to see what this commodity exchange means. So commodity exchange is an exchange where various commodities and derivative products are traded. So India has like 6 national exchanges apart from regional exchanges, and these are those 5, and as well as universal commodity exchange. So these exchanges offers trading in more than 30 commodity futures, including gold, metals, as well as the agri commodities, where the farmers are getting benefited. So how it actually works means it allows the investors to enter into the contract to either buy or sell these kind of items sometime in the future at a predetermined price, thus allowing the investors to hedge any volatility in price of these commodities. So it is like a binding future agreement. If there is any change or fluctuation in the market or economy, then it is not going to affect these agreement. So government has established a regulatory body, which is the Forward Markets Commission, in order to regulate these market commissions in 1953, and it was merged with SEBI in the year 2015. Now SEBI is the regulator of all these commodity exchanges. So why such a move by SEBI means? Because a large section of the market players believe that the commodity market turnover is largely dominated by the speculators and other participants who are not genuinely connected with the commodity segment. So in order to avoid that, and as well as in order to increase the transparency in the commodities market, the SEBI is now bringing this change in the commodity exchanges. That is, you have to disclose all the amount of transactions which is happening in the commodity derivative markets openly in a public platform. So how it actually benefits the farmer means, because this kind of online future markets is also applicable for crops. So the farmers can now easily find the price of their products, and they can fix the price of their goods more accurately, even if they are not active in these kind of markets. So how the farmers can do this means? By means of those 6 agencies which we saw before, right? So it helps the farmers in order to find the price for their products, and also it avoids the middlemen, who are the commissioning agents who are previously controlling much of this kind of market information, but now it is also eradicating the middlemen completely. So it actually increases the India's agricultural practices, as well as it increases the quality awareness among the people who are participating in these markets. So the next article is government move to exempt key foreign made drugs from the price control. So what the news here is, the Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers exempted the producers of new drugs who are patented under the Indian Patent Act of 1970. So as per this exemption, the ministry is not going to control the price of the new drugs for 5 years from the date of commencement of its commercial marketing in India. So it is amended in the drugs price control order. So these include the orphan drugs also. Orphan drugs means the drugs which is used for treating rare medical conditions. So what are the criticisms for such amendment means? The domestic drug makers as well as the civil rights activists, now they are complaining for the high prices as well as the unequal treatment. Because, for example, consider any foreign company, it is now coming to India and now they're getting this patent. So it is not coming under the ambit of the price control, right? So it can charge very high price for their drugs, actually demotivating or discouraging the domestic drug makers, because it discourages the Indian firms from developing as well as producing these kind of patented drugs. And this amendment is also against the India's position to WTO's TRIPS agreement. Right. So what is this TRIPS agreement means? It is the trade related aspects of intellectual property rights. And as per this TRIPS agreement, we can protect the copyrights, patents, as well as we can uphold the right holder's interest. But there is certain exception if it is for the public interest. But providing drugs to the people is public interest. But now it is against the TRIPS agreement, right? Because they are not giving any kind of exception to these kind of drug patents for the foreign companies. And also exempting orphan drugs from the price control regime ran counter to the national policy for the treatment of rare diseases. So we want to treat the rare diseases too in a better way, but you are not providing price control for the orphan drugs too. So it is against that national policy. And India lists nearly 450 such rare diseases, including hereditary cancer, autoimmune disorders, and congenital malformations, etc. So the next article is Lok Sabha okays the bill to make Aadhaar linkage voluntary. So we all knew that the government actually has decided to allow the voluntary linkage of Aadhaar, not mandatory linkage, it is voluntary, with the mobile phone numbers as well as with the bank accounts. So in order to provide legal backing to this government decision only, now the Lok Sabha passed a bill to amend three laws, including the Aadhaar Act, Telegraph Act, and the Money Laundering Act. So now the linkage of Aadhaar is voluntary, and as per the amendment, it puts the onus on offline verification of Aadhaar number holders, where the individuals are now verified through the QR codes and they don't need to submit any kind of biometric information like iris or fingerprint or any kind of demographic information to the data service. And also the amendment gives the minor the option to come out of the Aadhaar scheme on attaining the age of 18. So the next article is over 20,000 hectares of forest land diverted but clearances get struck. So what the news here is, the government has actually got the land or diverted the land from the farmers or from the common people for mining or industry projects or infrastructure projects, but not even half of the project's proposals has received its clearances. So only 30% of the total proposals has received its clearances in the last 4 years. So it is put forward by the Ministry of Environment. And the top three states with the highest number of forest diversion are Telangana, Madhya Pradesh and Odisha. And these kind of examination of the proposals are usually done under the ambit of Forest Conservation Act of 1980. So these are the number of proposals and its approval. Okay, it is the ratio of the number of proposals received and the proposals approved. So the next article is Submarine Cable System Needs Defense Ministry Nod. So what the news here is, the 2200 kilometer long cable system is going to be laid down from Chennai to Andaman Nicobar Island by the Department of Telecommunication. But before such process, the DOT will have to get the permission from three major departments. One is the defense clearance, and the second one is the National Board for Wildlife, and the third one is the State Pollution Control Board of Tamil Nadu. So this is what the Environment Ministry had made clear to the DOT. Before the commencement of such project, the Chennai-based National Institute of Ocean Technology have to conduct an environment impact assessment in the areas where the cable is likely to pass through the corals. So what is the main objective of this cable system means? It is to provide a secure, robust, as well as affordable telecom facilities in Andaman Nicobar Island, which is having a bandwidth speed of 100 Gbps. So this is how they categorize the cable system. So the last article is DBT scheme for nutritional support to TB patients. So we all knew that the government is actually aiming to achieve the complete eradication of TB by 2020 through the TB Mission 2020. So which is a part of WHO's target of eradication of TB by 2025. So in order to completely eradicate the TB, as well as in order to provide the nutritional support to the TB patients, the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has actually introduced this Nikshay Poshan Yojana. And as per this Nikshay Poshan Yojana, for the nutritional support of the TB patients, the government has actually provided them 500 rupees on a monthly basis till the patients get well. So it is financial assistance to the TB patients for their nutritional support. And as apart from that, they also created a platform for regular monitoring of the patients, and they record the details of such patients. And till now, nearly 13 lakh beneficiaries are coming under the ambit of this Nikshay Poshan Yojana. And one major thing here is the transfer of funds to the TB patients will receive directly in their active bank accounts, which have been linked to their Aadhaar cards. So this kind of implementation of the special medical scheme, which is offering help to the TB patients, will be coming under our government's National Health Mission.